Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, welcome back to our podcast, MTSB Podcast. MTSB Choice, credible, high quality, objective, integrity, construct, amalia, ahlu sunnah, and excellent.
Okay, today with me, Mepina.
And I am Mr. Erlu.
Now we are going to talk about the issue of SARA and unity in Indonesia. You know that the problem of diversity and unity in Indonesia. So, Mr. Erlu, I give you some question about it. The factor or the classification of difficulty problem, yeah, in unity study in Indonesia, because there are many tribes in Indonesia. So, in your opinion, that's the difficulty factor. Give a solution.
Okay.
About it.
Thank you, Ma'am Ina, for your nice question. So I'd like to explain and share my information or knowledge about unity in diversity and also SARA, or in English we call it as ethnicity, religion, race, and intergroup group relation. So from your question, how to unite or how to strengthen the unity between tribes in Indonesia, we know that our principle is unity in diversity. Although we have many various tribes or many kinds of tribes in Indonesia, but we must be unity, or we must unite each other. Because from the unity itself, it can bring harmony. Okay? So how to strengthen the unity between tribes in Indonesia is, first, we must spread good news or good information between the tribes. For example, we make a poster about strengthening the harmony of each other, and then give good information about the culture, and it can unite each other. And the second, it can be like the government must have good law for the let's say let me think for a while, the doer or the bad person, in order that the bad person cannot insult or cannot mock each other, so the harmony will form from it. And then the solution from the case that or from the way to strengthen the unity between tribes in Indonesia is, we must support the creativity of Indonesia children to make good content, in order that the people or the citizen can know which is the culture, which is the heritage from its tribes. So they will keep the heritage and culture, in order that there is no people or there is no person from overseas or from the country itself to take or claim the culture. And the culture and heritage will still kept,
okay,
or preserved.
And you know that the problem in children, the biggest problem in Indonesia for children is blasphemy. Okay, so what do you think about it, and how to solve it, and how do you reduce of the blasphemy in children in the environment of, in especially in the school?
Okay, thank you, Ma'am Ina, for your nice question or your next question. We know that blasphemy is bad act or bad activity which is done by the perpetrator or the doer who do insulting to another people or another group. We must erase the blasphemy between us, in order that we can bring the comfort, or we can bring the harmony between us. There are two kinds of blasphemy, as far as I know. The first is verbal blasphemy, and the second is non-verbal blasphemy. If it is verbal blasphemy, it can be like I insult someone, or someone mock me, or someone underestimate me by what's that? Stating bad word or stating hoax to me. And the second, non-verbal blasphemy. For non-verbal blasphemy, it is like physical action or physical thing. So someone who do or someone who hit someone in order that he can have what's that? It's like the satisfying emotion. So from this blasphemy, we must erase. And if that we know if there is blasphemy, we can report or we can what's that? Avoid it in order that there is no division. And how to unite children in Indonesia in order that they can be unity or they can unite. The first many activity is positive vibes. So the government or the leader of the village can have good activity or can hold an activity which can strengthen the unity between the children itself. Okay. And now I would like to ask you, Ma'am Ina. Okay. Why is hoax news related to Sara? We know that Sara is ethnicity, religion, race, and also intern group relation. And why hoax trigger what's that? Why hoax triggers a division?
This is caused by news content. Many news content that doesn't match with the reality. And then generally hoax news, yeah, is made. It has a certain tendency, especially for propaganda, or it has for divisiveness. And then the hoax news arises or exists, yeah, because of competition, or there is an discussion with something, a person or a group. Based the presentations above, yeah, it can be concluded that hoax news is not that accordance with the reality and the content of news. So hoax news is a trigger factor for division. This is the reason why the hoax news is this factor of division. So Mr. Arlu, why as a government is not anticipate of the problem for division? So many case, yeah, in Indonesia, yeah, and some case about the division, it doesn't the result of solution.
Okay, so we know that fighting on Sara factor, yeah, or Sara issue is a must. I mean, we must keep in touch, or we must have good friendship or good relation between others. By fighting on Sara or ethnicity, religion, race, and intern group relation, we can know or we can what's that? We can limit or we can. I'm sorry, not fans. It's not limit. We can handle or control that the big case or the big problem will appear. That's why fighting on Sara is a must in order that we can keep or we can obtain the good environment or the good relation between each other. If we don't keep or if we don't fight on Sara, I'm afraid that there will be big case or big problem will appear around or between the people themselves. And Ma'am Ina, my next question maybe will relate about your previous question. So my next question is, how do you get rid of SARA issue?
Okay, thank you Mr. Elwood for your question. There are some steps to minimize the issue of the SARA. Number one, about education and awareness. Strengthening education on tolerance, pluralism, and respect for diversity of cultural and religious from an early age. Number two, but the strict law enforcement. Take strict law action about the problem of SARA. And then you have you can build a group discussion. Why? Because in group discussion, you have a statement about the some people or some group that have the constructive or open-minded dialogue. And then the last about the policy of the government. So if the government have the strict of policy, so the problem of division can be reduced, because with the strict law, the and then the get prevent of the right individual or group. So it has a protection of the people or a group.
Okay, thank you Ma'am Ina for your answer. And the next question is, how does SARA can become the basic capital or main capital of students, I'm sorry, students association?
Student have must have the basic capital of the unity. For example, about the multicultural education. So as a government or as a teacher, with strengthening of multicultural education, have the have doing the all level in education, start from elementary school until the college. So certainly multicultural of education is very important. Number two, about within a shared narrative. Within a shared narrative in a nation of Indonesia or nation of the people of Indonesia, so that respect diversity and uphold the value of unity and strengthening social solidarity. With the strengthening social solidarity, as a citizen of Indonesia, we have doing to as a charity or a project with a humanity. And the last, about the active participate in democratic life, as for example, to participate in election or this public discussion or a development project. So the last question for me, Mr. Elo,
okay,
how to eliminate the movement of security disruptor in the name of the tribe?
Okay, Ma'am Ina, thank you for the question. So we move to how to eliminate the disruptors. We know that in erasing or eliminating the movement of security disruptors who use tribes as their cover or as their guard, is we must we must strengthen the legal law, or we must provide the strict law in order that the disruptors or the doer can be afraid of the law itself. If we don't have good law, if we don't have strong law, they will use the tribes as their guard to do bad thing. Okay, and then the second, we must or the government must provide good opportunities or good, what's that, work field, in order that every people can have the same rights to find or to work. And the last is every people must keep the belief or must believe each other, in order that there is no one who disbelieve and they do wrong thing or bad thing, and it cause the violence between the tribes or between the people. I think that's all, Mem Ina, for today's podcast. I hope the audience, or I hope the students who watch us, can add more knowledge. Thank you for your attention. The last we say, wassalamualaikum
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.